Ladies and gentlemen, I want to call the December meeting of the town board to order. If anybody wants to speak at the public comment period, you need to sign up on the lectern real quick, like, because we'll be getting to it just a minute for the public comment session. The first order of business is a pledge of allegiance led by Vice Mayor Vernon Curtis.
Pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
The first order of business is with the current board, and that is the approval of the November the 2nd, November the 16th, and December the 1st board minutes. Do I hear a motion or any corrections?
I make a motion. Pass.
Second?
Second.
All in favor? Just want to take a minute to recognize the service of Vice Mayor Vernon Curtis, Joyce Hanley, Alderman, and Farrell Jameson. It's just been a pleasure, and if I stay up here and talk anymore, I'm going to get all teary-eyed. Actually, I am, because I'm losing my number one nemesis right up here who corrects me every time I turn around, Farrell Jameson. But really and truly, I thank them for their service, and I know the whole other board does as well. Thanks, Farrell. Joyce, Farrell. Appreciate y'all. Okay, the next item of business is the oath of office for our incoming Board of Aldermen and the Mayor. And Mr. Perry, our clerk of court, will administer the oath of office to the incoming board members.
It's going to get mighty cozy.
Okay, fine, okay. Yeah, okay. So, yeah, just go right ahead and
take your name.
Thank y'all.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's my pleasure as clerk of Superior Court for Macon County to swear in our new board and our mayor tonight. And I'm going to ask Mr. McMahon, if you will come up first, please, and put that in your left hand. Raise your right and repeat after me. Say aye and state your name.
I, Brandon McMahon.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Aye, and state your name.
I, Brandon McMahon.
Do solemnly and sincerely swear.
Do solemnly and sincerely swear.
That I will be faithful and bear true allegiance.
That I will be faithful and bear true allegiance.
To the state of North Carolina.
To the state of North Carolina.
And to the constitutional powers and authorities.
And to the constitutional powers and authorities.
Which are or may be established.
Which are or may be established.
For the government thereof.
For the government thereof.
That I will endeavor to support, maintain, and defend.
That I will endeavor to support, maintain, and defend
the Constitution of said state.
The Constitution of said state.
Not inconsistent with.
Not inconsistent with
the Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Say aye and state your name.
I, Brandon McMahon.
Do swear.
Do swear.
That I will truly and honestly.
That I will truly and honestly
demean myself.
Demean myself
in the office of alderman.
In the office of alderman
of the town of Franklin.
Of the town of Franklin.
According to the best of my knowledge and ability.
According to the best of my knowledge and ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Say aye and state your name.
Aye, Adam Kimsey.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution.
That I will support the Constitution.
Of the United States.
Of the United States.
So help me God.
So help me God.
All right, Say aye and state your name.
Aye, Adam Kimsey.
Do solemnly and sincerely swear.
Do solemnly and sincerely swear.
That I will be faithful and bear true allegiance.
That I will be faithful and bear true allegiance.
To the state of North Carolina.
To the state of North Carolina.
And to the constitutional powers and authorities.
And to the constitutional powers and authorities.
Which are or may be established.
Which are or may be established.
For the government thereof.
For the government thereof.
And that I will endeavor to support.
And that I will endeavor to support.
Maintain and defend.
Maintain and defend.
The Constitution of said state.
The Constitution of said state.
Not inconsistent with.
Not inconsistent with.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Say aye and state your name.
Aye, Adam Kimsey.
Do swear.
Do swear.
That I will truly and honestly.
That I will truly and honestly.
Demean myself.
Demean myself.
In the office of Alderman.
In the office of Alderman.
Of the town of Franklin.
Of the town of Franklin.
According to the best of my knowledge and ability.
According to the best of my knowledge and ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations. Last but not least. Say aye and state your name.
Aye, Joe Collins.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution.
That I will support the Constitution.
Of the United States.
Of the United States.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Aye and state your name.
Aye, Joe Collins.
Do solemnly and sincerely swear.
Do solemnly and sincerely swear.
That I will be faithful and bear true allegiance.
That I will be faithful and bear true allegiance.
To the state of North Carolina.
To the state of North Carolina.
And to the constitutional powers.
And to the constitutional powers.
And authorities which are or may be.
And authorities which are or may be.
Established for the government thereof.
Established for the government thereof.
That I will endeavor to support.
That I will endeavor to support.
Maintain and defend.
Maintain and defend.
The Constitution of said state.
The Constitution of said state.
Not inconsistent with.
Not inconsistent with.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Say aye and state your name.
Aye, Joe Collins.
Do swear.
Do swear.
That I will truly and honestly.
That I will truly and honestly.
Demean myself.
Demean myself.
In the office of Alderman.
In the office of Alderman.
Of the town of Franklin.
Of the town of Franklin.
According to the best of my knowledge and ability.
According to the best of my knowledge and ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
I, Robert S. Scott.
I, Robert S. Scott.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution.
That I will support the Constitution.
Of the United States.
Of the United States.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Say aye and state your name.
I, Robert S. Scott.
Do solemnly and sincerely swear.
Do solemnly and sincerely swear.
That I will be faithful and bear true allegiance.
That I will be faithful and bear true allegiance.
To the state of North Carolina.
To the state of North Carolina.
And to the constitutional powers.
And to the constitutional powers.
And authorities which are.
And authorities which are.
Or may be established for the government thereof.
Or may be established for the government thereof.
And that I will endeavor to support.
And that I will endeavor to support.
Maintain and defend.
Maintain and defend.
The Constitution of said state.
The Constitution of said state.
Not inconsistent with.
Not inconsistent with.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Say aye and state your name.
I, Robert S. Scott.
Do swear.
Do swear.
That I will truly and honestly.
That I will truly and honestly.
Demean myself.
Demean myself.
In the office of mayor.
In the office of mayor.
Of the town of Franklin.
Of the town of Franklin.
According to the best of my knowledge and ability.
According to the best of my knowledge and ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Thank you. I have asked for a board for just a moment to make a very short, I don't know if you'd call it a speech or what, but I just want to welcome back the old board members and especially welcome you new members. You're joining a board tonight that has brought some innovative changes and new ways of doing things in Franklin. Many of the old ways of doing things are gone. The attitudes I expect to never hear expressed are, we ain't never done it that way, or if it isn't broke, don't fix it,
or we have always done it this way. I want to make sure that everyone on this board is always free to say, let's try it, or here's a new way to think, or to do something. We don't have to agree on everything, but I want to make sure that if there is any controversy between board members, that you bring this to me. If there is a problem with any town employees, you bring it to the town manager. The town manager is the go-to person if you need to ask a town employee to do something. This is the way it works in a council-manager form of government. This board sets policy, and the town manager carries out these policies. But this does not mean that you cannot speak to or compliment our employees. They deserve all the thanks they can get for the work they do. Stay away from groupthink. We do not have to be unanimous in all decisions just to appear that we agree on everything. Split votes are not unhealthy. They just show that we are not of the same just mind. I want each of you to take part in the League of Municipalities courses and the School of Government. I have asked our town manager to make sure our employees have opportunities to continue their education. When budget time rolls around, I want the board to consider increasing our budget, continuing education for this board and our employees. Sometime soon, probably about mid-January, we'll hold a retreat. We need to be thinking about coming up with a strategic plan, looking at Franklin 5, 10, 20 years down the road. We need to anticipate where we're going and how we're going to get there. We can do this by working with our employees, department heads, residents, business owners. We face some major issues. One of the biggest is the erosion of local control over our revenues, structures, and functions. You need to keep in mind that municipalities demonstrate the value we add to our community's quality of life. Technology is changing, and we must change with it. Technology must be used for service delivery, citizen engagement, and economic development. We must practice productive partnerships with the county, other governments, and the private sector. We must be in a position to adapt quickly to cultural and demographic changes because Franklin is changing. We must embrace diversity because it is coming in many forms. Or put it another way, social issues are not a constant. Social issues are forever changing. Never hesitate to sharpen your leadership skills. This is an investment in the town's future. You are the town's leaders. Always reach out and work to empower our residents, our visitors, and business owners. Expect the unexpected. For better or worse, things will be changed little by little, one by one. If you have an agenda, lay it out. Don't keep it a secret. Our hiring policy for the town is this. It is not who you know, but what you know. Openings for employment and service on town boards, commissions, and authorities are advertised so that everyone gets an equal chance for employment or to serve the town. There is an unusually good relationship between the board and the town employees, and I would hope this association will continue. We have the same good relationship between the people that volunteer to work for the town on the various departments that they help us with, and I appreciate it. This town prides itself in open government. We exist for one reason and one reason only, and that's to conduct the public's business. Always disclose any situation in which you might have a financial or personal interest in a town decision. If you need any information concerning the past or operation of the town, go to our resident expert, Alderman Billy Mashburn. Billy has many, many years of service on this board and is an invaluable wealth of knowledge, and I have picked his mind many, many times, many, many times, sometimes after bedtime. We have shared information for many years, and I appreciate your long service to the town. Finally, keep your sense of humor. If at any time being on this governing board gets too squirrely or is no fun, come see me. I'm the oldest. I'm being harassed beside this. Thank you. Appreciate you, sir. Good afternoon. I'm your advisor. All right. I think board agenda, I see no changes except you can scratch under new business the message from the mayor. I've already done that. Do I hear a motion to adopt the town agenda, the board agenda for tonight, as stated?
So moved.
A second. All in favor? The next item of business is the appointment of the mayor pro tempore, and that means vice mayor. Do I hear a nomination for vice mayor?
I'd like to nominate Patty Able. She would be very able.
Patty Able be able. Do I hear a second?
Second.
Are there any further nominations? All in favor of Ms. Able as the vice mayor? Welcome.
You can.
Well, yes. You can. The next item of business, under new business, it is a very distinct pleasure of mine to present a plaque tonight to Mr. Buddy Huckabee, the director of the Franklin High School Band. We had one of the most successful Veterans Day events the other day, and it would not have been except for the Franklin High School Band. Mr. Huckabee, we have a little token of our appreciation that we want in the band room, sir.
Okay.
You can do that.
All right.
Thank you so much. And tell the band we really appreciate it. And we're looking forward to next November the 11th.
Definitely.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Can you come around, please?
Do what?
Can you come around, please?
I reckon.
Reckon? Reckon?
They want to read it.
Thank you.
We'll see you November
11th. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I have two people signed up for the public session. The first is Mr. Joe Sabinski. Welcome, Joe.
Thank you. I'd like to thank the mayor and the town board for the opportunity to speak here this evening. And I'm coming here to speak concerning the Franklin Fire Department. And I'd first like to recognize, especially on this evening when new board members are seated, and acknowledge your service to our community, and I thank you for that. On the December 1st previous town board special meeting, the action was taken to instruct the town manager to seek a full-time fire chief. I'm standing up here today to express support and acknowledge and honor the service that our Chief Warren Cave has done for our community. Chief Warren Cave is, in my opinion, the best fire chief in Western North Carolina. As you're aware, through his leadership, work ethic, and knowledge, Chief Cave has provided benefit to the citizens of Franklin in several ways. Some highlights are improving the ISO rating, resulting in savings to each and every citizen of Franklin, upgrading our equipment, improving staffing so the citizens of our fire district enjoy 24/7 coverage. Chief Cave is well known and well respected within the fire service and wider emergency services community in our county and across the state. There are ways Chief Cave benefits you that you may not be aware of. Under his leadership, Franklin Fire Department has developed a level of teamwork and unit cohesion that's not achieved overnight. It takes dedicated firefighters willing to put in the hours of training, learning, communicating, and developing. The men and women of Franklin Fire and Rescue are exemplary of such dedication. To take the dedicated effort of individual firefighters and mold them into the most effective fire department takes trusted leadership. We're fully aware that a full-time fire chief may be in the best interest of the town, but from the vantage point of the men and women at the end of the nozzle, we've served under the best fire chief available. I look forward to continuing my service in the fire department under the leadership of the next chief. That being said, Chief Warren Cade will always be my chief. A second point I'd like to address before you is communication. And we as a fire department understand how much time you already dedicate to the town and that each board member has responsibilities that they take on, one of those being the fire department liaison. We would invite each member of the town board to come visit us at the fire department, and we may have a method for you to do that. Communication is a two-way street, and we'll make an appropriate effort on our part to communicate with you. A fire department comprised of paid and volunteer firefighters is known as a combination department. It's understood in the fire service, and I'm sure by town administrators, to present challenges that are not experienced by a department that is either 100% volunteer or 100% paid staff. The dedicated members of Franklin Fire and Rescue are fully willing and able to work in conjunction with the dedicated members of the administration of the town of Franklin to move forward to serve the citizens of our district. We have a great community. Each one of us here tonight, no matter what seat we may occupy, love to proudly declare, I'm from Franklin. Within our beloved community is another community of men and women who put their lives on the line for you, and that's the community of firefighters. And excuse me for the noise, but woo! I love being a Franklin firefighter.
Thank you so much, Jeff. The next item of business is Larry Davis from the public comment. Hey, welcome, Larry.
Thank you, Bob. Congratulations on all the new members. I guess I just want to bring up that the fact that there is no noise ordinance in Franklin, North Carolina, and I don't understand why. Maybe I live in a bad area of town that my neighbors like to party 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. But my problem is that our town police have no jurisdiction, no authority to do anything about it. They can come out and say something to them, but when they leave, there's nothing that they can do about it. I'm stuck, and other residents are stuck, living with the noise. What I want to know is what I need to do. I'm open for suggestions. Am I supposed to move, or am I supposed to just suck it up and bear it like other people? What is the order? That's what I want.
I think, Larry, one of the things I can address tonight is the fact that noise ordinances are the most subjective type of ordinance you can pass. One of the problems is getting a definition of noise, and I'd be glad to have council speak to this because you're not the first person by any means that has expressed this. And it's probably something that we need to address at our retreat again.
I'm happy to address it, Mr. Mayor. As those of you who were on the board at the time recall, we several years ago knew that we needed to reexamine our nuisance ordinance, of which the noise
that's part of it, yes.
It needed to completely be repealed and start from scratch because it really had a lot of deficiencies in the way it's going to be enforceable. That included all of the noise ordinance and it needed reexamination anyway and was repealed at that time. I don't think it was with the intent to leave it in that state forever and ever, amen. I do think it's something that we, as perhaps beginning with the ordinance review committee, could take a look at and possibly reinstitute in a more modern and enforceable form.
Well, I'm open for anything. I'm stuck with people that keep myself, my family, my children awake till 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. And when the police come and turn around and drive back out, because they can't do anything. I'm told at the dispatch office there is no ordinance. There's nothing they can do. Just do that. So my children have to stay away and then go to school the next day. I can't understand why there is no ordinance. I can't understand that why residents of Franklin have to deal with this. It's not fair for any residents. It wouldn't be fair to any of you board members if a lunatic next door was screaming and hollering all night and keeping y'all awake. It's not fair for me or anyone else that y'all have been dealing with. I have been run to every single building in this town from the mayor. Bob, I told you about this for so many years. It's pathetic. I have been run to the sheriff's department, the police department, the magistrates, anyone you could think of. The health department sent me to somewhere else. I live next door to a house that has put a trailer in there, which it doesn't have the right to, according to the deeds. It doesn't have the right to do this, but it's there. And I have 2 and 3 families living in it, plus 2 or 3 families living in a house. And they all like to party.
All right, well, why don't we do this? Actually, I know exactly what you're talking about. I had a little similar situation the other night. A fellow was tuning a car with no mufflers at 2 o'clock in the morning.
Exactly.
And while his wife or significant other was cussing him out. So I know what you're talking about. Mr. Setzer, will you look into this trailer situation?
I've been complaining about that trailer for 5 to 7 years.
Are you aware of it? So, yeah, let me check this out.
If it's a deed restriction, then that's more of a civil matter than a zoning.
It is a deed restriction. According to the deed, it says that it's a single dwelling lot. But they put a trailer in there, and there's at least 2 families, sometimes 3 families in it. And there's, I don't know how many living in the house.
Larry, if you don't mind, let me take this under advisement, and Madam Manager, will you make sure that it's added to the retreat agenda? We will discuss it. I don't know if we're going to be able to come up with anything, but we're certainly going to try.
Well, thank you.
And I'll tell you that right now.
I appreciate it.
Don't waste long to come back and see us.
I tolerate it as long as I can. I blew up Friday night.
That's fine.
Crazy.
Well, so, we understand.
I don't want this to happen. This is what it's gotten down to, where neighbors are fighting for neighbors, and that ain't good.
When
I lose my temper, I lose my temper. I guess all of y'all know that.
Well, I have a visit run out this time, too. Yes. I'll be back to see you.
Thank you.
I will.
And good luck.
Chief Adams, I'll holler at you, and we'll go by and talk.
All right.
Okay, that ends the public session. The next item is a presentation from Stephanie Almeida of the Macon Overdose Prevention Coalition. Oh, there you are, Stephanie. Welcome.
Thank you. Give me a little bit of time tonight, Bob, to discuss the Macon Overdose Prevention Coalition. As some of you will remember, I came in the spring and discussed a grant that was available on the national level. I did apply for the grant, and it was a pretty rigorous process being federal. And we were granted one of 18 in the nation, us being the most sure in the South. So I'm pretty proud to say that Macon County has $100,000 to fight overdose prevention here in Macon County. Most of the other organizations that received this grant were large hospitals, large community organizations. There were just a few of us that were as small as we are. And so the grant is being held by Full Circle Recovery Center, which is my agency here in Franklin, a prevention, substance use prevention and treatment agency. And right now, the Macon Overdose Prevention Coalition meets once a month, and we're trying to bring all the pieces together to meet the requirements of the grant. The four major goals are to purchase naloxone, which is a medication that reverses opioid overdoses, and it increases the availability to the public of having those overdose reversal kits. The second thing is to train licensed healthcare professionals, law enforcement, fire departments, first responders, EMS, in using naloxone overdose kits, as well as making sure that the local medical providers are educating the folks that they are writing opioid prescriptions to about how to reverse an overdose, what are the signs and symptoms, and we're also advocating for co-prescribing. So anytime a prescription is written for Percocet, let's say, that they're also offered a prescription for naloxone, so they have both medications available to them in case of an accidental overdose. I know, especially in the elderly population, sometimes we take our medication and we're still in pain, and we say, geez, did we take that medication and take another one? And so the risk is real. And also, the community that's using drugs here in Macon County, to make sure that they have overdose kits available to them, but that they're also receiving referrals to treatment. Right now, the system is not easy to access, as you know, through the mental health subcommittee. It's often difficult to find services, and even more difficult when you don't have any money to receive services. And so one of the things that I'd like to do is put together a one-page handout so that everybody that gets an overdose kit would also get a list of treatment options available to them, all the way to Asheville, unfortunately, we'll have to incorporate. And that we also have educated providers in the community that know about what's available for treatment for Macon County residents. And then the last piece, of course, is the data collection. Within the past 2 years, Macon County Health Department had received some Project Lazarus money, and that money started a data collection process at the health department level. And so the biggest piece of this grant is the coalition and coordination with all of the departments. So I come to you tonight to ask if the town would sign an MOU with Full Circle Recovery Center and Macon Overdose Prevention Coalition so that we can work together to reduce the morbidity and the mortality associated with opioid overdose here in Macon County.
Stephanie, I appreciate we can't do it tonight because we'll have to study it and council will review it and I'll get back in touch with you. But I do want to offer my congratulations for getting this grant. And I don't know if y'all know what naloxone is or not, but if somebody overdoses, a spray up the nose, or does, I think that's the primary way that they prevent it. It brings them right out of an overdose, even though they may be unconscious. So There have been over 600 lives saved in the state of North Carolina already with naloxone.
As of last week, we have 1,517 overdose reversals in the state of North Carolina. That have been reported to the North Carolina Harm Reduction Coalition. And those aren't emergency rooms. Those are folks that have actually used the kits on maybe their child or their husband, or even if they found somebody in the bathroom.
The beauty of it is anybody can administer it, even a mayor. I mean, it's very simple to administer, and it is life-saving. And if it's not an overdose, you're still not going to hurt anybody. Stephanie, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
And I will pick this up. Yes, please do answer a question. Anybody else?
I was just wondering, do you have any idea what the size of the problem might be in Macon County?
Well, it's often awful difficult to figure out exactly how many people are using opioid prescriptions, and even more difficult to see who's using them illicitly. I can tell you that the Project Lazarus data that was collected when they did have the grant, and I can email this to you, Barbara, I'd be glad to. We know that in 2008, there was about 115 emergency department visits, five. So there's been a dramatic increase of folks that are going to the emergency room for things of this nature. They didn't find any heroin overdose deaths, but I can tell you as a provider, we have quite a few folks in Macon County that are using heroin. The other number that was interesting is the number of deaths in Macon County. 2012, we were at about 8 or 9, and we're up at about 12. So they've increased a little bit. But you've got to remember, our population is so small, so when we're looking at numbers, six people in our county versus 100,000 folks, which we don't even have, our numbers are in relation to that very high.
Any further questions? Stephanie, we'll get back with you the next day or so after council makes a review.
You all have my cards with my cell phone number. Feel free to call with any questions you might have.
Thank you for what y'all are doing. Very vital to the community. The next item is Mr. Crabtree. Tim, are you? Oh, there you are. Come on up. Street closing requests.
Hello. Welcome. My father was here at the last meeting to request a street closing for New Year's. This year we're planning on doing the same New Year's kind of party that we did last year. It's the Ruby Drop, if you're unfamiliar with it. We built a big ruby, we drop it at midnight, we throw a big party. It's something, when it's cold outside, for the residents of Franklin to do, and for tourists who might be traveling through town. So we're requesting, as we did last year, we requested the street be closed from the town square to the next red light, right past the restaurant there. This year we've requested to close the entire Main Street in hopes to expand the event. We'd really like to drop the ruby in the middle of the square where the main Isla Street and Main Street intersect. And the hope in that is to get more businesses involved and every party that's going on. So if Bowery's got a party, Rathskeller has a party, we have a party, the brewery has a party, at midnight everybody can converge together in one location that's not exclusive to Motor Company Grill. And they can still do that if the ruby is dropped where it was last year. And lots of people did last year. We had about 1,000 people from our estimates come up to that location. But I feel like it would be so much better if we could do it right in the middle of the square. So that's our request. And if you have any questions, I'll be able to answer them.
Board? Madam Manager?
Yes, one thing for the board to consider, I know that I've kind of spoken with Chief Adams as well about this, something we may want to look into is our Main Street is set up a little bit different than most Main Streets in that there's numerous entrances and exits, which makes it a little difficult at night, especially with that, the night that it is being New Year's Eve, which puts kind of a little bit of a burden on our police force trying to man those entrances and exits. So something to think about, I believe maybe at our retreat in January, is to try and set some standards of what we need to try and accommodate businesses, kind of a game plan for street closings requests, because quite frankly, I don't believe that the town necessarily has the resources right now to try and do that for a night event.
I think that's...
For the full street, I'm sorry, Mr. Mayor.
Yeah, that's the main thing. It came up at the two Winter Wonderlands about closing Main Street completely. But it will be talked at the retreat. We will make that an item to Chief Adams, and police will be there at that retreat. No, it's after the, I don't know whether...
May I offer a solution? I know Tim and I have chatted a little bit. It would be, I think it was manageable, Chief Adams, I know you're here, what we did last year, if the board would maybe at least entertain the idea to allow the businesses to close at the first traffic light down to Bryant Funeral Home. That is manageable, if that's something the board would like to do, and I'm certain Mr. Crabtree would be very appreciative of that, until we can get a plan in place to try and help businesses accommodate in the future for street closing before we can provide more manpower.
That's what I was leading up to, exactly what the manager says. Tim, unless the board has a different feeling, I just really don't think we can do it this year. But we will cooperate in every way we can about how you had it last year.
Okay.
And we will do everything we can to slow traffic down and keep it off as much as possible.
Okay. So then I guess my request changes. So.
Well.
And that's fine.
It's probably not what you wanted to hear.
Right. And one thing, that's sure. A big thing for the future, because this is an event that this will be the second year, and we don't plan on stopping it anytime soon. And I like to see that Main Street is growing, and I think it's growing in good ways, and if we can get more businesses involved next year and have, we'll get the whole street, then we can get more events going on in the street as well. Like Folk Festival used to be, you know, I know it's at night and it's cold and, you know, that.
I do have one question. There's not a possum in that, is there?
No live animals will be dropped.
I'll tell you, thank you guys for what y'all are doing. And I heard a lot of compliments about people coming downtown. And, we appreciate it. I just wish we could have met your request. Yes.
So I motion that we go ahead and grant the closing from the traffic light in the door panel down to Bryant Funeral Home.
All right. All in favor? Any further discussion? All in favor? Okay.
Thank you,
sir.
Have a time and discretion of the police department.
All right, Mr. Setzer, we need to set a public hearing for a special use application for the scenic ridge development. You're up, sir.
Yes, the planning board met in November to look over a special use permit for Scenic Ridge for property builders, property owned by Scenic Ridge Properties LLC. They've been through their neighborhood compatibility meetings, and the planning board met and discussed it, and so we need to set a public hearing for January. A special use permit.
You have said it's 7:05 January meeting. Is that agreeable with the board? All right, I'll entertain a motion. We set public hearing 7:05. Have a motion. Second? All in favor?
All right. Mayor, before we leave the topic, just as always, let me just remind the board members that it's a special use matter, which is quasi-judicial.
Oh.
For our new members, we have had some quasi-judicial hearings, I suppose. Essentially, when that matter comes before the board, you're setting the judge and jury of that matter. So it's not appropriate to talk to anybody outside of it, gathering information on your own about it. The essential point of it is, we're going to have a hearing on it. You need to form your opinion of whether or not you should have a special use permit based on the evidence that you're put before you at that hearing and nothing. And if you have any particular personal ties or anything to do with that project, you need to disclose those. But just generally don't discuss it with anybody until we have the hearing.
Okay. Okay, we had a motion and a second and a vote, I believe, so we're set 7:05 for the January meeting. Mr. Stetson, you also have an appointment of a member to the town planning board?
I actually have three. We advertised a couple months ago in the paper and on the town's website for an opening for the planning board. Well, I've been gathering some applications and resumes. Well, in that meantime, one of our other previous planning board members was elected Alderman. So then we have two openings. So what the planning board met last month on November the 16th, and we had three total resumes, and the planning board voted to recommend that Mr. Todd Duval and Susie Letford be appointed as regular membership to fill out the board. And Mr. Todd Duval was our alternate member, in-town alternate, and our other resume was from Andrew Raby, who lives in town, and to appoint him as the alternate for the in-town seat, which would have to be three appointments. These would be for three-year terms.
What is the pleasure of the board?
So moved.
To go with the recommendation of the planning board. Second. We have a second. All in favor? Okay, all right, Mr. Sutcher. Okay. I believe I have one more for you. Mm-hmm. Board, the text amendment to the Unified Development Ordinance regarding tasting rooms to the town planning board.
Yeah, we've been approached and had some lengthy discussions, been going on for a couple months, for a potential text amendment for a tasting room to our UDO for a defined use. And our town attorney has drafted a sample ordinance of what the definition of a tasting room would be, as you should see in your packet, along with the text amendment application. And if it's at the pleasure of the board, the board is down to the planning board, and if there's a discussion on it, if it's something the board would like to potentially add as a use.
Any questions from the board about it? What's the pleasure of the board?
Send it to the planning board.
Second?
Second.
Okay. All in favor? All right, sir. Thank you so much. Finance officer, Ms. Doster, I think you have some budget amendments to bring before the board.
I do. The first three is for our police department. The first amendment is the appropriation of funds that were received from the sales of the 2016 police department calendars. And this is done annually. The revenue of $2,500 is the portion that the calendar company returned back to the department once the sales are complete. So that's what the first one is.
All right. What's the pleasure of the board? Motion to accept the budget amendment?
Sure.
Okay. All right. Is there a second? There is a second. Any discussion? All in favor?
The second one is to appropriate funds that we received from gun deals, from the sale of the police vehicles through there, and this is to appropriate that money into the vehicle maintenance line to help with covering repairs.
Any discussion from the board? Such a motion?
We move that we accept the motion.
Okay. Yeah. All in favor? Okay, you have another. I believe we have one more.
I think we have two or three.
Oh, okay.
The next one is for the police department. Also, it's the appropriation of the funds that we received from an insurance settlement, a total loss settlement for a 2008 Crown Vic, and that money also is being appropriated into the vehicle maintenance line.
Any questions? Motion to accept.
Second.
All in favor? All right.
Well, we do have one for planning. It's at least a different department. And this is to appropriate the zoning funds that we received actually in June of 2015. These funds were actually unexpended as of June 30, and we need to appropriate those into the 2016 budget. To help cover the expenditures related to the town's cost with consultant review and recommendations on the Weeby Gap Road cell tower matter.
Do I hear a motion?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor? You have one more.
I have one more, and it's the police department, and it's record the lease purchase proceeds for the police vehicles. In the November board meeting, the board approved moving forward with the submission the credit application for this lease to Ford Motor Credit, and we received the approval confirmation from Ford Motor Credit, and this appropriates those funds.
Okay, and you need a motion just to appropriate those funds.
Motion we check.
Second. All in favor?
Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Foster. The next item is the approval of the 2016 Town Board regular meeting schedule. Madam Manager.
Yes, Mr. Mayor and Town Board. What you have before you tonight is the annual adoption of the 2016 Town Board regular meeting schedule, which is attached in your agenda packet. It's the first Monday of each month at 7 o'clock, unless it falls on a holiday. So we're just asking tonight for a motion to approve the schedule for 2016 regular meetings.
Any discussion? I'll entertain a motion.
I move.
Is there a second? All in favor? Okay. Madam Manager, we also have a proposed change to the town personnel policy regarding the accumulation of comp time.
Mr. Rick.
I'm sorry, that's it's just force of habit, excuse me.
The one that we can go back on, it's the approval of the 2016 Town of Franklin holiday schedule, and that is falls in line with the state holiday schedule. So if we could get a motion, if it behooves the board, to approve the 2016 holiday schedule for the Town of Franklin, please.
Such motion.
Motion to approve.
Second?
Second.
All in favor? All right, that passes. The next is the proposed change to the town personnel policy regarding the accumulation of comp time. Mr. Simons,
Mr. Mayor,
our Human Resources Office.
When the personnel policy was adopted in 2010, there was a stipulation put in there that you had to use all of your comp time within 30 days. I'm not sure if that's ever been enforced, so that's just kind of impractical. So what we're asking for tonight is just more discretions for some of the department heads to have where employees can use that stuff adversely impact in their departments, and to cap it comp time at 60 hours so they never use
that. Any discussion on the board about this?
Is this two separate issues?
It is two separate issues.
We're
talking about a comp time max and also a date.
Okay, that's. And your recommendations, how many days?
60 hours.
60 hours?
The match group recommendation, we would also look at our personnel policy and the date, removing the 30-day cap, it's just not reasonable.
Are you suggesting there be a longer cap?
Yes.
Yes.
Like what?
A year.
6 months to a year, and it would really depend on the department, because fire and police may be a little bit different if there was an emergency situation. So this would just allow the department head to have a little bit more discretion, and when the employees within that department could take their comp time.
But if whatever cap we put, that takes the discretion out of the department head.
It can, possibly.
So you're not saying we want to do 6 months to a year, are you?
It's Mr. Simons, what did you
prefer? What are we talking about?
I think we need to. The 60 hours is it's practical.
Let's say that is. But what about the length of time to take?
Well, it just gives Chief Adams.
And let's say 30 days is not practical. Are you saying a floating scale?
If you cap it at 60,
yeah.
It'll,
a year?
Our recommendation would be a year, based off of the maps.
You can also
but if we made it a year, we would have to have the discretion of the
department. No.
Well, only when we took it. Within that.
Only
when you took it. Within
true.
Exactly.
Yeah, so you can keep it open-ended. Unless you guys decide differently.
You're yeah.
So we're just capping it. They have to use it within
a year. You're going to waste our man over there, Ed. How are you keep? What is this?
Well, I guess what you're saying is there's an opportunity here where some departments may just need different policy.
That's where the discretion comes in, yes, sir.
That's why you want to leave it open so that
each department individually.
It doesn't adversely impact. You don't have to use it for 30 days. If something comes up, we have an emergency.
In further discussion?
What we have now is it working?
Yeah.
So we're not actually adhering to our own personnel policy.
I don't have any trouble if the department head wants to set it at 6 months or 9 months, but I want a cap, a year or something.
No more than a year?
Yeah, I want a top level.
Here.
Yeah.
For employees to earn.
Yeah, 60 days.
Well, I move that we got a year and we cap it at 60 hours.
That's fair.
Can you get us over that?
Yes.
Yes.
Is there a second to Mr. Nashville's motion? Any further discussion?
Yeah.
I heard you say yeah. Any further discussion? All in favor? Okay, thank you, Mr. Simon. The next appointment is, Madam Manager, the appointment of Mr. Bishop to the Tourism Development Authority.
Yes, Mr. Mayor and Town Board, what you have before you tonight is a recommendation from the Tourism Development Authority Board to appoint Mr. Donnie Bishop, who is the owner of Frogtown Deli, to serve a 3-year appointment on the Tourism Development Authority Board effective December the 7th, 2015, until December the 7th, 2018.
Okay. Any discussion? Any questions from the board? I'll entertain a motion to appoint Mr. Bishop to the Tourism Development Authority Board.
I move that we appoint Mr. Bishop.
Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor? Okay. Madam Manager, you're up again. The appointment of Mr. Tim Crabtree.
Yes, Mr. Mayor and Town Board, what you have is the second appointment to the Tourism Development Authority Board. The TDA met and would like to recommend to the Town Board the appointment of Tim Crabtree, who is the owner of Motor Company Grill and most recently Crabtree General Store, to serve a 3-year appointment on the TDA Board, again beginning December the 7th, 2015, and ending December the 7th, 2018, please.
Okay. Can I take a motion? Second. All in favor? All right, you're up there on one that I really don't know that I understand, but it's a municipal agreement for transportation improvement project B5125. I think that's the bridge.
Yes, sir. Mr. Mayor Ward, what you have before you tonight, and John, please feel free to jump in. Back in, I believe it was 2013, the town board had discussed moving forward with allocating $36,000 to the bridge project of the new town bridge that's going to be effective, and the start date is August of 2016. The attorney has looked at this agreement. This just reiterates all that has been discussed before, that the town is willing to continue with their agreement for the $36,000 to start that project in August of 2016. And we just need an authorization of signature from the board tonight if you still wish to continue with that.
And I have reviewed it. Their standard agreement when they begin a project in a municipality just says that we, you know, basically they're going to be in charge of the project except for that one betterment that we're agreeing to pay for on the bridge. And other than that, it's more or less their project.
Any questions? Any further discussion about this? All right, I'll entertain a motion to go ahead and sign this agreement.
I'm a member that we go ahead. I don't want to waste 1 second.
No, we've waited long enough. Just a second. All in favor. Okay. There's one other real quick item of business that's not on the agenda, but it's within my power as the mayor to make appointments of liaisons. Because of a time element, I'm appointing Ms. Abel, the liaison to the fire department, because Mr. Jameson was that liaison, and I'm going to make that appointment tonight. And we will be making other appointments at the January meeting to the other committees as liaisons. Under legal, counsel, I believe you're going to talk to us about the policy for police body cameras.
Yes, sir, Mr. Mayor. I apologize for the short period of time that you have had, which is basically none. We knew we had new members that were coming on the board anyway. So each of you has a copy of a proposed police department policy that would govern mobile video recording, including dashboard cameras, and it's not within your packets. If you don't have a copy, I will get you. Essentially, Mr. Mayor, this just is a departmental policy, but one that we thought the board, in addition to other police department policies, we're going to, one, begin to have a more concise and consolidated handbook of departmental policies. This being the first one, because I understand the police department has now an opportunity to get some body cameras as well. I think they already may have had dash cameras. So this lays out the policy for when and how mobile video and audio recording is going to be done, and how the recordings themselves are going to be managed after they're made. Again, I recognize the board hasn't had much time with this, and so I'm happy to answer any questions you have about it as to what the policy does. And don't know whether how far we can get with it, but happy to answer your question.
Let me ask you this: how far do you think we ought to get with it? Our chief Adams.
I'm comfortable with it as policy. I mean, I think it does what it needs to do in terms of safeguarding of video recording, how those are managed once they're made, in terms of being public records and reviewed by the chief and or council as needed before anything's been released. I think it outlines, Chief can probably speak to this better than I can, but it outlines the circumstances under which we're directing officers to make recordings, and then, as I say, then manage it, the data thereafter. Again, this is something that probably would fall, if it was implemented immediately, it would probably fall within authority of Chief to just do. I think that his intent and the administration's intent is to make sure that the town board is aware of and in agreement with procedures like this. And also, this is kind of a hot topic at the moment, so for that reason, I wanted to at least make you aware of it and ask for approval when you're comfortable with it.
So I think I'd just like to ask the board what you would like to do, if you want to approve it, or if you want a little more time to study it, or what would you prefer that we do?
What's the downside for a little time to look at it? I mean, you're comfortable with it, but if it hits a fan, it ain't you, it's us.
Yeah. I don't know that there is any downside. And Chief Adams, is there any reason that we need to rush this through, or can it wait until next month?
We don't have it right now, so we don't rush.
So I'm getting the feeling that the board and council and the chief would like to, since there's no real rush, this will be an agenda item for the January meeting. Okay, whatever, for everybody. I don't think we need a motion for it. All right, Councilor, you're back up again.
Mayor, it was under state law, the purchase, consumption, and possession of beer and wine is basically presumed to be legal. The exact opposite is true of the possession, purchasing, and especially public possession of fortified wine and liquor. For that reason, our ordinance dealt with, and without an ordinance within a town such as Franklin, public consumption of beer and wine would be presumably legal. And as I say, possession of liquor in public is governed separately. But for that reason, the ordinance we had originally dealt only with consumption of malt beverages and wine on public streets. And so the ordinance that I brought you for consideration would add to that open containers, because we haven't dealt with that separately. And I understand that has been an issue on occasion.
Have you come up with the wording of that?
Yes, sir, Mr. Mayor. It just adds possession of open containers of malt beverages, more unfortified wine and beer wine. has also occupied or controlled portions of the town, so streets and sidewalks, whether or not we actually own them, they're controlled by the town by law.
So what do you need, what do we need? Do we need further discussion? Do we need a vote?
I'm happy to answer any questions you have, but you, the board is in a position to approve this now. It is a police power type ordinance.
Based on council recommendation, I know that we accept this amendment.
Is that second?
I'll second.
All in favor? All right, I have a couple of them. Oh, everybody did vote, right? Okay. I have a couple of announcements. The town employee luncheon will be December the 18th, 12 o'clock tomorrow. Town offices will be closed December the 23rd, 24th, and 25th for Christmas. And as it is my practice, I like to give everybody on the board an opportunity to kind of come around the table if anything's on your mind, anything you want to bring up. Ms. Collins, we'll start with you, sir.
Not bad.
All right, then. Ms. Abel? Mr. Billy?
I would like to say I'm very pleased that people are starting to apply for positions on some of our boards. When we've been advertised, I mean, sometimes no one applies, and it's great that people are stepping up. So I appreciate it, and I'm still here. Thank you.
Yeah, you're still here. He might flip that on us. Ms. McMahon, welcome, sir.
Presently, thank you. Thank you very much. I do appreciate it. But no, nothing at present. I'll probably think of it after I get in the car on the way home.
Ms. Kinsey. Excuse me. Well, it's been a pleasure tonight to bring some folks on the board and get through this lengthy agenda. I want to thank everybody, and I want to thank all of our guests tonight, everybody that showed up tonight. We appreciate it. That's citizen participation, and that's your civic duty. We appreciate it. So I will entertain a motion to adjourn.
I'll move.
Is there a second? All right. All in favor of adjournment?